All right, today I'm going to show you how I made this cooker. Let's check it out. All right, welcome back to the smoking plank, pretty much picking up where I left off. And yes, I cut that out with my plasma cutter. I'll leave the link in the description. But I'm upgrading the steering shaft, also basically the tongue for the wagon. The first one made it like 2 yards and it broke. This one should hold up definitely. After getting the pipes notched out, got everything welded together, I had some bearings and bearing cups left over from some exercise equipment that actually fit really nice. You can see there it runs real smooth and it's actually pretty stable. Surprised. Going to attempt to cut out a chamber door for this, and there you go. I lost some footage, but you know, you win some, you lose some. I made cardboard templates for my smoke collector, and I'm going to get these traced out onto some steel, and I'm going to get that cut out. Here's the steel. Get it cut out and get it all prepped, and we'll get that welded into place. Can't wait till this thing starts taking a little bit more shape. Soon, very soon. Welding the lip on, I had a little bit of warpage, you can see there. I didn't fully clamp the top piece, and I had a little bit of warpage, a little bit of heat warp, but I'll make do here. We'll get it bent out into shape. All right, you can see I got my collector all put into place, and we'll get that tacked up and welded in. There it is. And also, you can see my welds are getting a lot better, nice even heat penetration, and they're decent for farmer welds. All right, these cooking grates, I'll leave the link in the description. They're actually stainless steel grates from a Weber Summit 600 series, and they fit perfect for a 60-gallon cooker. And also, we're doing this today. I've been wanting to make one with a foldable stack. Also, it makes it easier to get it into places. It's this far. Let's build a fire and check this thing out. Looks like it's burning super clean. I am really happy with this. And it's pretty even across the chamber. It's not too bad. I'll take it. Fire's burning nice. Yeah, I'd say it's a win. Alright, here's my water pan set up. I used a drywall mud pan, stainless steel heliarc pan, and I took this idea from fat stack smokers and kind of made it my own a little bit. And so far, I think it's gonna work good. My good friend Brad, he did this axe handle on his CNC. It was like a laser CNC, and he did an awesome job on that. Thanks, Brad. And I took some angle iron and welded it up, and here you can see, mounted it to the cook chamber. Turned out really good. I really like this. Thanks again, Brad. And it's pretty much done. Ready for paint, you can see here. I would like to change this a little bit to get more of an angle because it doesn't completely give me open flow, but it's been working okay. And the handle, it holds up nice. The grill grates are in, just gotta do a little bit more cleanup on the inside, get some oil in there and get it seasoned up. The water pan set up, I'll show you guys how that works here a little bit later. And the firebox, I went in and I put in some red clay brick. It's not actual fire brick, but I've used it before and it works. My firebox grate is actually from a Weber Spirit Grill. And yeah, it has come a long way since on paper and just a pile of scrap. But you know what? It was a vision and I seen what it looked like. And I went with it. Yes, the paint link will be in the description. And there it is, all painted up. And it is looking cool. I have to say I'm pretty impressed with this one. I don't know. I say, let's quit messing around and build a fire. I use a little bit of lump charcoal to get a coal bed started, and then once I get the coal bed started, I just toss in some splits of oak, or pretty much whatever wood I have on hand, and this oak is what I was actually splitting in the last video that I posted. And I just stack it in there, no real way of stacking. You just want a little bit of air gap in between. Maybe I'll do a fire management video. And here it is. We're gonna see how it works. Never said I was accurate, but you know, doesn't look like it's leaking. See how it looks on the inside here. Yeah, it works as it should. I'll take it. I actually designed it so it would fill up into the elbow without overflowing, and I guess it would work for that, but it leaks around the nut a little bit. Having the axle set up that way makes it really nice to use jack stands. There you can see my grease drains. I went with stainless steel valves instead of the brass this time. You can see there a little bit of smoke escaping, and you can actually fix that by just a certain way. If you draft the door right, it has no leaks anywhere. I was actually pretty impressed. You can see it's flowing pretty good. It's just getting warmed up. Oh yeah, I did add a gasket in there. Didn't really need that either, but we'll get it up to temperature here and test it out. Alright, this is the bread I'm going to be using. I got it for free. I did not pay for the bread. It was given to me. I actually donated. And we're going to test this grill out. A lot of people use biscuits for this test. Biscuits are expensive in this climate, you know, and I really didn't want to waste the money on it, and I had someone hook me up with some free bread. So we're going to see what the heat pattern looks like on this thing. All right, there you can see. It's pretty typical for an offset. Got it hot on the one side, pretty decent in the middle, and then throughout. Got a good spot for chicken. I can't wait to try it. Yeah. Not too bad. I'm really happy with that. I am really happy with this thing. Burning clean, burning nice. The fire brick definitely helped it out, stabilized the temperature. Water pan's working flawless. It's really nice and seasoned. It's got that nice black color. Yeah, let's cook something.
My favorite type of weed was cocaine. I'm Mr. Body Catcher,
slaughter gang soul. Hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?
Would you just look at it? Holy cow, that brisket looks awesome.
I got a snake in my boot and I like it.
There it is. It's got a perfect bark on this. This is definitely probably my best brisket I have ever done. It is trimming up nice. It had an awesome jiggle. And oh yeah. Yeah, look at that. Perfect bend. The fat is rendered nice. The pull apart. Yeah, it doesn't get much better than that. I'm at a loss for words because I'm drooling too much. I don't know. All in all, I am super happy with this smoker. And also, here's some pork butts that I did a few days later for a cookout. It's definitely not the last video you'll see with this smoker. And like always, thanks for watching.